What a night, guys. I was here at Coronado Springs for like 4 hours. I'm just trying to hurry up right now, get packed up. I basically just woke up about, I don't know, a half hour ago at 9:30. What is it? It's a little after 10 right now, but if you guys missed it, this is day 3 of my little adventure here. Links are below for the first 2 days of this trip. I was at Disneyland for Star Wars Galaxy Edge, and then yesterday was at the Haunted Mansion 50th anniversary event. Then I flew from California to here in Florida. I had a quick layover in Vegas. Unfortunately, the plane, it was delayed for like another hour, which pushed me back. Long story short, by the time I got to Orlando last night, with Magical Express taking a while, and then having the very long walk from Grandestino Tower back here to the Rancho section, I end up getting to my room at 4:45 a.m., and I was up since 5:15 a.m., so yeah, pretty crazy. And then by the time I went to bed, it was 5:30, and then I set my alarm for 9:30, so yeah, 4 hours of sleep. I'm actually not feeling terrible, so that's good. I'm quickly trying to hurry up and pack up right now. Then I'm going to meet Becca, and today is the first day of Disney Fairy Tales event, so super excited for that. Going to go down now to the RSP, check in for the event, get our credentials, pick up all of our product, and then continue this adventure. All right, just got my bag packed up here. I am late. I wouldn't recommend doing it this way. If you want to get your pins, either go super early in the morning and get your pins, or later in the afternoon. Going at this time is going to be a pretty long line, but that's really all I can do right now because I have other things I have to do this afternoon, so we gotta go now. First, I'm gonna take these bags down to Grandestino Tower, have them hold them for a bit, and then we'll head down to the convention center, get our pins. Guys, look who it is. Back at it again, it's Disney Kitty.
Hi!
Back for round two.
Back for round two.
We did this event last year, and here we are again for Fairy Tales.
My second annual pin event.
Yeah, Super Bowl pins.
#SuperBowlOfPins.
Yeah, yeah. Here's the sign I want to show you guys. We are at the Coronado Springs Convention Center right now. There's the little sign, and we're going down to pick up our pins.
So for pin pickup.
Dang.
It does get calmer as the day goes on.
Becca, we made it.
We made it. We made it to the front.
How long was that?
2.5 hours.
2.5 hours. We are here picking up our pins. So some time has passed since I last vlogged. I forget even where I was. I think I was walking to Epcot. Yeah, I think that was where I was at. Anyways, I was pretty much out of commission the whole afternoon. I had to go run over to Epcot to check out the event stuff before the actual event tomorrow. And was there for a few hours, and then I came back. My room was finally ready here at Dolphin, so I checked into my room, threw down my stuff. Becca and I filmed an unboxing video, which will be up on the channel here pretty soon. And then grabbed something quick to eat, and now here I am back in the room. I did mention yesterday when I was out in California for the Haunted Mansion 50th event that I was gonna be spacing out my vlogs. I think I'm just gonna include this vlog today with the Fairy Tales event pin haul. So all of my pins I have here in this bag, I'm gonna show you guys now. And this is basically day one of the Fairy Tales event. After this goes up on the YouTube channel, next will be the Disney pin previews, which is very popular, and then probably Beck and I's unboxing video, and then we'll continue on to the vlogs a few days later. All right, let me show you a look at the pins that I got now. All right, first I gotta start off with the event logo pin. This is limited edition of $7.50, retail price $17.99. And then there is the Walt Disney World annual pass holder exclusive featuring Walt Disney with his dog there. That dog doesn't look very happy, but Walt is. It has a gold frame with a bunch of different dogs on it. That one is limited edition of 1,000. All right, next we'll start up top here with a few more dog pins I got. Here's the Nana. I really like this one a lot. All these have a retail price of 20 bucks. I think they're at least 750. Yeah, they all are connected with their little leash there, which is unique. Moving down here, I like these ones a lot, the Cleo and the Bolt, because they have crazy pop-out elements on it. Look at that. Look how big that is, that bubble on there. That's wild. Same here with the Cleo fishbowl. That one pops out pretty far. You have the Lucifer cat pin there. I think it has a little bit of a movable element or pin-on-pin element there. Elliot's game night. Nice glitter embellishments on the back of that one. Fox and Hound pin here. This one's cool as well. It has the pop out there with their heads. This is one of the interchangeable Fairy Tale logo pins. I got the Pua pin. Love this one here, the Tank Gang Finding Nemo. Honestly, I think it's my favorite one just because I love aquariums and fish and Finding Nemo. Got this Stitch pin, this is the Adoption Day pin. And here's the Abu pin, that's a nice one. Pop out elements there. This is another Stitch pin. This is a sketch on the front, but you open up and you have him on the inside. Here is a Pluto and Fifi pin with the artwork there in the background. There's Pluto at the bottom and Fifi. Sorry for the background noise, illuminations, fireworks are going off in the background. But here is the Park pin set. Love this one. Another favorite of mine, you have the Carousel of Progress pin with Rover. The Gravedigger and the dog from Haunted Mansion. The dog from Space Mountain, little robot dog there. And the Pirates of the Caribbean parrot pin. Absolutely love this pin set, and it's pretty rare, coming in at LE250. Retail price on that one was $100. So there is my little event haul from Disney Fairy Tales. I also got the Magic Band over here. This Magic Band is LE1000. I have last year, so I figured I gotta get this one as well. I like the color, it's like an aqua blue. Got different characters on there, like Cleo at the top, Pascal, Figaro, the Fairy Tales logo. Just all around super nice, and says Walt Disney World there at the top. I hope you guys enjoyed day one of the Disney Fairy Tales event. Pretty much just check-in day. You can pin trade at Coronado Springs, pick up your pins. That is the gist of day one. Tomorrow is the main event in the convention center over here at Epcot. So be sure to stop back on the YouTube channel here very soon for a continuation of my Disney trip vlogs. Thanks for watching, everyone. See ya.